Traditional control systems have been disconnected from real-world data beyond the factory floor. Not because that information was not wanted, but because it was hard to connect cloud services to I/O control systems. But with the Internet of Things, all of that is changing. Now, developers have APIs to restfully access databases and cloud analytics, even earthquake reports and weather forecasts, among many other data sources. What's more is that all of these different endpoints can be connected easily with Node-RED, so all this cloud data is more accessible than ever. In this workshop, I'll show you how to use Node-RED to request weather data from the Weather Underground API, then parse, format, and send it to a Snappack controller, where it can be used to make control decisions. With Node-RED, you can quickly and easily connect your physical I/O control systems to real, live cloud data. My instance of Node-RED is running on a Groove Air 1 box. It's an industrially hardened IoT appliance that is running Groove as well as Node-RED. The endpoint for my data is a Snappack learning center. It's basically a Snappack system with a controller, several I/O modules, and a rack. We use it for training here at Opto 22. This front panel simulates some typical I/O signals like a meter, temperature sensor, potentiometer, LEDs, switches, and a buzzer. The controller is running a convenience store strategy that's loaded into its memory. My goal is to have the convenience store outside light controlled by the sunrise and sunset times from the Weather Underground Astronomy API object. I'll get started by logging into Node-RED on my Groove box. The Groove AR1 uses both encryption and authentication. The first step is to get the data down from Weather Underground. So to get the flow started, I'll drag in an inject node and go down to the function section to get myself an HTTP request node. I'll configure this to get the API object from the URL http://api.wunderground.com/api/my-api-key/astronomy to get the sun and moon rise and set times. And finally, /q/public-weather-station and my station ID. And end it with .json. You'll need to get your own Weather Underground API key by signing into the developer page on Weather Underground. I'll have this return a parsed JSON object so that it's easier to reference the fields that I need. Before I package this data up and send it to my pack controller, I'll scroll back up to the output section and drag in a debug node to have a look at the object that's outputted. Wire the flow together and edit the debug node to output the complete message object. Now I can deploy and inject the flow to see the outputted object. Here I can expand payload and sun phase to see sunrise and sunset have both hours and minutes. To get the path to this object, I'll use the first button in the debug window to copy this path to my clipboard. Now I can format it for Node-RED using a function node. I'll scroll down to the output section and drag one onto the wire. Right now, Node-RED has four separate fields, so to make the comparison easier in the controller, I'll build a string that has hour:minute:minute format so that the string length is always 5 characters. To do that, I'll paste the path from a clipboard, add message to the front, and use this to reference the fields that I need. Now I can add the colon character and the sunrise minutes. Also, since I can see that the hour can be a single digit number, I will want to make sure that everything has a leading zero, so instead of 6:30, I get 0630 for a consistent string length of 5 characters. To do that, I will append a zero to the front of my fields, and then take those entire strings and use the function slice with the parameter -2 to only get 2 digits. Now that I'm confident that I will always have a string length of 5 characters, I can save this new string as a variable sRise. To get sunset, I will copy this string, duplicate it, and change the field sunrise to be sunset, and save this as a new variable sSet. To get this data out of the function node, I'll return a new object using the curly braces and hand in the fields sunrise to hold sRise and sunset to hold sSet. Now that I'm done with this function node, I can get this data into my SnapPack controller. To do that, I'll go up to the Opto section and drag in 2 SnapPack write nodes. I'll edit the first node and select my Learning Center controller. It's already set up to be a RESTful server with an API key, ID, and value set. You can find out how to set these up for your controller at developer.opto22.com. With the controller selected, I'll enter the string variable tag that I need to enter called sunrise. This is already set up on the controller. The value that I'm writing to this tag is held in message.sunrise. I'll edit the next node to use the same controller, also write to the string variable, only this one is going to be sunset, and it takes the variable message.sunset. Now I can hit done and wire these 2 nodes to the output of the function node. I'll keep the debug node in place so I can see the data appear and modify the timestamp node to inject at a specific time at, say, noon every day. Now I can hit done, deploy, and every day at noon, this data will be refreshed in the controller and I'm free to do anything I want with it. Let's head over to Pack Control and see an example I set up earlier. This flow takes the real time from the pack controller and assigns it to a string. It then compares that string to the sunrise and sunset the node red hands in and determines whether or not it's day. If it is day, the outside light needs to be turned off. Otherwise, the light needs to be turned on since it must be nighttime. After an instruction is made, I delay 5 minutes before checking to see if the light needs to be toggled again. The actual tags that this is held in is sunrise and sunset. And the I/O point that this data controls is the outside light. Here you can see the outside light is on, and neither the sunset nor sunrise times are currently in, because it's not noon and they haven't been automatically injected. To give myself some initial data, I'll go over to Node-RED and manually inject the flow, and see the data appear on the right-hand side. Now, when I switch back to Pack Control, I can see that sunrise and sunset have been updated and the outside light has automatically been turned off since it's daytime. So there you go. I've used Node-RED running on this AR01 to make a RESTful API call to a cloud service and use the returned data to drive a control system. This is just one example to show you how you can link APIs to your physical I/O. To find out more, check out workshops.opto22.com. Thanks for watching.